Every state in the union is run by a governor. They are the head of their state's executive branch of government. The governor makes policy and budget recommendations to the legislature. They also enforce the laws passed by the General Assembly and are in charge of the state's military, the National Guard. In that sense, the governor is like the president of a state. And like the president of the United States, governors run for election every 4 years. When a governor is up for election, the race is called a gubernatorial election. And why the strange name? Gubernatorial comes from the fun Latin word gubernator, which means governor. It also derives from gubernare, which means to steer or govern. As a state official, a governor often faces different issues than politicians like presidents or those running for U.S. Congress. Being the state executive, Georgia's governor must be open to the concerns of all Georgians, no matter where they live or what party they choose. And those concerns tend to focus on what affects citizens' daily lives. Far from the heated and exciting topics we hear about in national elections, governors must concern themselves with making sure their state is working on a daily basis. Presidential elections tend to focus on issues like foreign and domestic policies and federal budgets, whereas governors are more likely to discuss schools, roads, and law enforcement. Maybe you think schools should get more state funding or the driving age in Georgia should be lowered. Those are decisions that can only be made into law if the governor signs a bill passed here in the General Assembly. When proposing legislation or signing bills into law, Georgia's governor has to consider what is best for the entire state, not just for specific groups of people. For instance, have you heard about the two Georgias? No, not the country over by Russia, here in our state. Georgians sometimes talk about the two Georgias being Atlanta and Notlanta. As Georgia's capital, Metro Atlanta has a population of nearly 6 million people, and that's almost 60% of the state's population. With so many people, the needs of Atlanta sometimes seem like they take priority over the rest of the state, and that rest of the state is sometimes called Notlanta. When an issue or problem arises that concerns people, they expect the governor to take action. And typically, these issues are local ones, concerning the city or town where voters live. But the governor is said to wear many hats. They must be concerned with the politics, legislation, and initiatives that affect everyone in the Peach State, regardless of where they live. Historically, Georgia's governor has been a member of the Democratic Party since Reconstruction, the time period immediately following the Civil War. But since 2002, like much of the South, Georgia's executive branch has been made up mostly of Republicans. Many of Georgia's governors have served more than one term. Governors are limited to 2 consecutive terms, but they can run again after waiting 4 more years. Some of the Peach State's most famous governors have been outspoken critics of the federal government. Others have introduced programs that have earned national recognition. For example, during the Great Depression, Governor Eugene Talmadge disagreed with President Franklin Roosevelt's New Deal programs. Lester Maddox, governor during the Civil Rights era, disagreed with the federal policy of racial integration. And Zell Miller brought the state lottery to Georgia to help fund college education through the Hope Scholarship. Now, not every governor sticks to Georgia politics alone. Some go on to serve in the federal government. Carl Sanders and Richard Russell both serve in the U.S. Congress. Sonny Perdue became the Secretary of Agriculture under the Trump administration. And of course, there's Georgia's most famous governor, Jimmy Carter, who became the first U.S. president from the state. So not only is the governor an important position within the state, it can be a stepping stone to gaining a national office in the future. But what really matters is that the governor is serving all Georgians and trying to improve their lives.